Want to impress your friends on social media with a super fast, easy technique that's going to make them go, "Oh my God, wow, that is so cool." Be sure to stick around because this video is for you. So today I'm super pumped because we're going to be jumping into Lightroom and then we're going to be looking at the radial filter. That's what's going to make everybody go, "Wow, that's so cool," when they look at your images, because clearly that's what they do when they look at mine. Enough said, let's jump straight into Lightroom. So this is the image that we're going to be working on today. So before we do, I'll show you a little before and after. So on the left, that's straight out the camera. On the right hand side, I've added a preset and then I've done a little edit to it. And then from this point, normally what I would do is then go in and add a radial filter. So on the top right hand side, we're going to click radial filter. That's going to bring this window down here. So before we jump into what those little bits do, I'm simply just going to click on the image and then just drag down, and then that's going to create this shape that you're seeing here. If you wanted to make this bigger or smaller, you can click these squares just here, and then that's going to allow you to drag it. And then if you come outside of the circle or whatever shape, egg shape that you've got, you then can rotate that also. So what does this allow us to do? If we press O on the keyboard, that's going to bring up this red here, and basically that red is going to affect your image, or it's going to show where it's going to affect your image. So if I press O just to get rid of the red, and I'm going to drag the exposure right down just to show you, and then if I was to push it completely up, that's where it would be. If I come down to this section where it says invert, and then again if I press O to show you, so now Murphy's face isn't going to be affected, but anything around Murphy will be affected, which is basically what you can see with that effect just there. So let's get rid of that. So again, if we bring up the red, again on the right hand side at the bottom, we have what's called a feather. I like to keep mine around 52, 54. That's just going to give a nice feather. So you can see how it's going from red, 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 and then it slowly starts to fade out. Basically, that's what the feather is. So if we were to go further to the left, that's going to decrease the feather. So you're going to get a much harder line. You have to be careful with this, because if you were to add an effect, so if I show you, see how you're going to get more of a solid line. So it's going to look obvious that you've added that in post. So that's something you need to be careful of. So again, let's bring up. And then if we were to go again to the bottom where there's feather, if we were to push that completely to the right, then that's giving you a real small little feather, which in this case isn't going to work because it's too small. So it's going to cover Murphy's face up. So I'm going to go to around 52. So let's delete that because I'm not happy with that. And then again, we'll just drag. Let's get rid of that because I want to see, first of all, where I'm going. So again, if we just drag the squares, and then I'm going to push it around just a little bit, and then I'll turn the red on just to see where I'm going to adjust. So at the moment, Murphy's quite dark in this image. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag the shadows up. And that's just going to help any shadows in that area stand out a little bit more. I'm then going to go to the exposure, and I'm not going to change it that much. I'm going to bring that down just a little bit around there. So if we go to the bottom, there's this box here. At the moment, the effect is enabled. If we click that, it's going to turn it off. So that effectively would be before, that's after, that's before, and that's after. So go to the top, because I'm happy with that one, and then we're going to create new. So this is going to allow you to create a new selection area. So again, I'm going to go to Murphy's chest because that's quite dark. And then I'm just going to increase the shadows and then just a little bit on the exposure. So that's both of them. There's before and after. See how this dot here has white and then it has black in the middle? That's saying that that one is selected. If I really wanted to select or change this one, if I simply just click it, that's then going to allow me to change that one. So that's the one that is active. This one is still there, but obviously not selected. So anything I change is going to change the one with the black dot in the middle. Again, if I click that, it's going then to change this one just here. So again, if we go over to the top right and then we click new, now what I'm going to do is create a bigger one. I'm going to press O so I can see my selection, whereas this time I don't want to affect Murphy. I'm going to unclick invert, and then I'm going to drag it up, and then I'm going to use the squares again just to bring the egg shape out, and then I'm going to push it up. I'm going to get rid of the red so I can see where I'm going to be changing, and then I'm simply just going to drag the exposure down. The key with this is not to drag it completely down, because that's not going to look right. You want to do as many of these layers as you can. So again, we're going to create a new one, and you also want to make them all different shapes. So this one will rotate around a little bit. Again, let's invert, because we don't want to change Murphy. So I'm happy with that. Again, we're going to bring the exposure down just a little bit, and then I think we'll make one more, and then this time we'll rotate, and then we'll push it up, and we'll turn it on. And again, it's doing the wrong area, so always check where you're going to be changing. And I don't want to affect Murphy's face too much, so we'll deselect to see where we are going to change, bring it down just a little bit, and then what we're going to do now is I'm going to show you a before and after. So there's your before and there's your after. There's your before and there's your after. See how it just really makes Murphy stand out just a little bit more. And then if we go to effects on here, so I closed the radial filter by just simply clicking it, that closes it down. And then I'm going to go to effects, and this basically is a vignette. So all I'm going to do is if I drag slowly to the left, the image is going to get darker, and then if I push it to the right, then the image is going to get whiter. Whereas generally you don't find that you use that one, you're going to use a vignette. So I'm going to push it slightly left just a little bit. And then you feel by adding different effects or different layers, it makes it look a little bit more natural, because the light is slightly different. Whereas if we just dragged one down, it would look a little bit weird. So I'm just using midpoint just to push that effect a little bit close to Murphy. Roundness, slightly right, and then feather just a little bit. And then again, if we press the box, that's the effect. So there's your before and there's your after. So if we close the window, we're going to have a little look. So on the left is completely out of camera, on the right is it's had a preset, it's had that preset adjusted very slightly, and then it's had the radial filter adjusted, so it just helps Murphy stand out from the background. And what I'm going to do now is simply show you an image that I've added a radial filter to. So on the left is the before, on the right is after, and then if I go into the radial filter, I'm going to turn it on and off. So there's your before, there's your after, there's your before and there's your after. Just makes Murphy pop just that little bit. And then again, I've added a vignette, so there's your before and there is your after. So that is the two. I did go in and then remove the flies that were around from Murphy. So again, this one's had a preset, so the left is out of camera, on the right has had a preset, had the preset adjusted, and then I've added the radial filter.
So I hope you enjoyed today's video. Don't forget, when you add the radial filters, you want to add multiple ones, and it just makes the light just fade in a little bit more natural than just by dragging one completely down. If you found value from today's video, be sure to hit that like button. It makes a real big difference. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And if you want to see me edit through a complete video, then be sure to click on this video here. And guys, I will see you soon. Want to impress your friends with... Want to help your videos stand out a little bit more on social videos? Want to impress your...